As the sun rose over the Space Coast, think of this slow-moving trip to the launch pad as one small step in the next trip to the moon.
We're really, really excited about it. It's a big day for us.
Of course, it's a slow process. Missions like these require sophisticated systems. Launch pads are more than a place for the launcher to be placed, more than a spot where the magic happens. We marveled at the Falcon Heavy earlier this week, and by late next year, the Space Launch System with an Orion capsule in place is expected to lead this mobile launcher on a lunar orbit mission.
This is our launch day, you know, from a hardware development standpoint, and we've been focused on the construction and the testing for you know, a couple of years now, and to see it, you know, coming to fruition is just amazing.
The size can fool you. It is a big structure, roughly 38 stories tall. The testing of all the systems will last through September. Then it's back to the vehicle assembly building for a few extra tests. Then
we'll be ready to start stacking the rocket. So the next time we come out to the pad, we'll be with the rocket, and it will also we'll be doing what's called a wet dress rehearsal at that point, where we're actually fueling the rocket.
So looking ahead, there's a planned unmanned lunar orbit scheduled for 2020. Then in 2022, a similar flight with people on board, and then they hope within 5 years to be landing on the moon. Reporting in Brevard County, Dave McDaniel, West 2 News.